Battle of Natural Forces tonight at the O'Connell Sports Center on the campus of Clark College. The Nippon Tornadoes are led by number one Hikaru Sasaki, 6'2 guard, averaging over 23 points and 3 rebounds and 2 assists on the campaign. The Volcanoes counter with number 5 Jeremiah Dominguez, the former All-Star guard from Portland State University in his 4th IBL campaign, but making his debut in Vancouver tonight. It's the Tornadoes versus the Volcanoes. Which natural disaster is greater? Tune in tonight to find out on FVTV Channel 11. Murray over to Blackledge.
Boy, someone took a picture of that. Frame it.
Hartman for another 3.
Oh, yeah, baby.
On fire. And there he is again, Josh Tarver. Murray, he says thank you very much. And he spots an open Pip Bledsoe.
Oh, yes.
Down it. Smart. Look at the emotion.
Very smart.
Look at the emotion.
This is your Vancouver Volcanoes.
And a welcome back. The O'Connell Sports Center on the campus of Clark College. It was a nice spring Sunday in the wonderful city of Vancouver, USA. The real Vancouver, not that Canada one. However, there's good things going on in here tonight. It is your hometown Vancouver Volcanoes looking to extend the perfect home court record this year versus the visiting Nippon Tornadoes. A story in the making. Mike Koreski with you this evening. Good evening to you on FETV Channel 11. And to my right, he is the Kid Flash to my Flash. That is Gary Akiyama. So Gary, last time they were here a couple weeks ago, 137-104 victory. What needs to change for Nippon tonight to compete a little more on this one?
Well, to compete some more, what they need to do is they need to rebound, which is going to be difficult since they're not that tall. So they're going to have to depend on their quickness and penetration. And also the defense. They're going to have to block the barriers. Double teams and half-court traps by the Volcanoes last time. They need to get through those.
Sounds like a plan. And to hear a couple more updates, a couple more storylines for tonight, She's here. It's Nicole DaCosta. Nicole, talk to us. How are you?
Good. What's up, basketball fans? Nicole DaCosta bringing it live from the stands. We are going to have a lot of fun tonight. Japan back in town. But hey, we have not lost a game on our home court. And we don't want that to happen tonight. We have Jeremiah Dominguez joining the team. His first game with us tonight. So we're super pumped about that. And to, you know, even it out, Andre Murray out on the bench. He does have a hurt ankle. I just talked with him. He's taking things a little easy, but he's going to have fun watching the game just like us. So back to you guys. Unless Gary wants to suit up. You want to play tonight?
Let me think about that, Nicole. Let me think about that.
Let's do it. There's a red jersey for you. I want to see those point guard skills that you talked about.
Well, Jeremiah and I could team up together. We're about the same height.
All right, well, we'll be back soon. We'll talk about Dominguez some more, and we'll talk about this matchup some more. So coming at you real soon, it will be the Tornadoes versus the Volcanoes, coming to you on FETV Channel 11.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, for the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
And welcome back, IBL fans and basketball fans and Mike and Gary fans of all ages. The O'Connell Sports Center is the place, the location, Clark College, the city, Vancouver, Washington. And it is the IBL in mid-season form, and the Volcanoes defending their perfect home court record for this 2013 season. You see Josh Tarver coming on out, and we'll talk about these players all game long. So, Gary, what's been the key to the Volcanoes here at home? Why are they winning all the games?
Well, you know, one of the main things are, you know, they feel so comfortable at home because they know tradition, they don't want to give that up. But defending the castle, I always say that, but that's what the mantra is, started by Andre Murray. But defense is key for these guys. They play so tenacity with defense, offense. They're just starting to click on all cylinders now. And so they're 9-3, Bellingham's 10-1, so they want to keep the tradition going. So I look for a good game. You know, don't discount Japan just because of their lack of height, but you got to counter with their quickness.
Okay, now, Gary, did you say defending the castle or invading the castle?
I hope I said defending the castle, but maybe I did say invading the castle.
Yeah, I'm not sure how you broke it down, okay. But I liked it just the same. So looking here for the Volcanoes tonight, the starters, Josh Tarver driving the bus, the number 8, 6'3 guard, Oregon State University. Number 20, Chehalis Tapscott, the Warriors, 6'6, Portland State forward. He dropped 40 points and 20 rebounds versus Japan last time. They probably went to bed with nightmares of Mr. Tapscott. Number 31, Paul Hafford, 6'4 forward, Portland State University. Sharpshooter, almost 22 points a game. And J.R. Moore, number 32, 6'9 center, Portland State. And number 11, the Rocket, Yasuo Iajima, 6'4, formerly of the Nippon Tornadoes. Last time, Gary, he was 2 of 12 in the starting role versus Nippon. What does he need to do to have a better shooting percentage?
Well, I think what the Rocket needs to do is just build his confidence early in this game. I think he was a little bit nervous. First start of the IBL season for him. First start against his former team. So I think he needs to settle down and make a few shots and you know, gain his confidence.
And that's Tarver on the cut. 2-0 Volcanoes right off the bat. So starters for Nippon. Number 1, Hikaru Sasaki, 6'2 guard from Tsukuba University. Over 23 points a game, 3.4 boards, 2.6 assists. Number 2, Kosai Ban, 5'4, University of Kokushikan, Japan. Over 8 points and almost 4.5 assists a game. Number 4, Takato Hara, 5'5 guard, Tokai University, almost 20 points a clip. Number 5, Glenn Holland, 6'5 forward, Cascade College, 17 points, almost 11 boards. Not bad for 6'5. And rounding out the starters, it is number 10, Anthony Kelly, 6'6 forward, University of Washington. I'm going to let that slide.
Okay,
being
for right
a
kid, now.
I'll still let it slide. 8 points, 11 boards a game for Mr. Kelly. And almost 2 points right there. And that was number 5, Glenn Hollins back with it. Last time they played here, Gary, Glenn Hollins worked his tail off.
Yeah, he's a workhorse, one of those blue-collar workers that will keep on doing things quietly, and then all of a sudden you look at the stats, and then you see his scoring. So he's a quiet player, but he gets the job done.
And Anthony Kelly hit the three there to briefly put the Tornadoes up, but the Volcanoes' answer was Chehalis Tapscott doing what he does best. A couple of other storylines to look at, Gary, for the Volcanoes. Jeremiah Dominguez making his big debut in Vancouver tonight. And he's had some impressive stats in his stints in Portland before with the Chinooks, which we'll talk about later. Also, Tyson Christie making his home debut for this campaign, and also making a debut is a dunk from J.R. Moore, and a very nice feed from Mr. Tarver on that one.
Yeah, that's going to be important for J.R. to get his confidence going, too. Normally doesn't start, but I think the more he can produce, the better he'll get.
And also, Mike Ward is back. Had the bad ankle injury a couple weeks ago, but the former Olympia Rain product from a few years, he's back for us. Dominguez, we talked about. Tyson Christie, 2013 home debut for him. Tiefenthaler is back, second night for a row, back with the Canos. So, and then who is out? Number 20, Chehalis Tapscott hits it there. And I'll catch up, Gary.
That's okay.
There's only two players not playing tonight for Vancouver. Well, there's a couple. Hurt guys. Andre Murray, he had that nasty spill on Friday night on his way to 41 points, but towards the end of the game, nasty fall on his ankle. But as Nicole was saying at the top of the broadcast, he should be back in another week or so. And Gio Bain, they are sitting him. Lots of fluid in his knee, apparently, from Friday. A big, like, softball-looking knee was what Gio was sporting.
Well, Gio, it's important just to keep him rested and get him ready for the playoffs. I mean, we got enough talent on that team, as you know, Maverick, that most of those guys sitting on the bench can start. So although we'd like to have him there 7 foot, we got a lot of other capabilities with Teef, J.R. Moore, that can fill the void.
Well, and don't forget Jake Carlisle also.
Yeah, big Jake.
Consummate veteran. So missing tonight, no Pip Bledsoe, no Alex Hartman. No problem, right?
Yeah, we shouldn't have a problem, really. On paper, this should be an easy win. But, you know, as we always say, Mike, you never know in the IBL.
That's right. And Yasuo Rocket, something happened to his finger there. He is being escorted into the locker room. Open wound is, I'm thinking, what happened, Gary. Okay. Did you see anything that happened there?
No, I thought he was just fine there, and all of a sudden he had to grab a towel, so I think you're right. Got to get that taken care of.
So into the game is Mike Ward, number one. Welcome back, Mike. We've missed you. He's had a great campaign for Vancouver, coming over his first year with the Canos. And let's see, 16.4 points a game, 3.7 rebounds, 4.3 assists. At the line for the Tornadoes, number four, Takato Hara, 5'5 guard, hands the first one. Japan looking pretty good so far, Gary.
Yeah, they are. Free throws are their strength. If there's a strength on this team, you know, shooting about 75% all season. So that is one of their keys.
Well, and I'm thinking that three ball's got to fall early tonight for them to compete. Kosai Ban and Sasaki really have to get the stroke going.
Yeah, Sasaki's already had it 1-3, so let's see if he can keep it going.
And Kosai Ban, he can cause some problems, definitely, for matchups on the other end if that three gets going for him. Tapscott puts it down, breaks the tie, 10-8 Vancouver, 9:20 left in the first quarter. Japan coming right down, and there's that three ball we were talking about. But unfortunately for Takato Hara, no chance.
Yeah, a little bit shorthanded there. They'll get it going, though.
Well, and,
whoa.
And who do we got here? We got a blocking foul on Kosai Ban against Josh Tarver.
Well, that at least shows the quickness of the players, and him and Tarver, just, you know, good sportsmanship there, just kind of congratulating each other on their aggressiveness.
Oh, is that what they were doing?
Yeah.
You plowed me over. Congratulations on being aggressive. How would you say that in Japanese, Gary?
Yeah, I have to dig deep on my vocabulary on that one.
Oh, Googs, that's why we have fun. That is why we have fun. So there's a steal from number 10, and he is taking this thing down all solo. Oh, almost for Anthony Kelly, but here's Hafford back. One guy to beat, and he does it off the window. And that's the thing, when Kosai Ban's your last line of defense, Gary, it's just you're at a disadvantage.
Yeah, when you're only 5'4", you're going against 6'4". And it's not going to happen.
Yeah, that's just pure inches, Gary. Pure inches. All right, and there's Sasaki, who we talked about at the top of the broadcast. Over to Ban for three. And Nahara with the rebound, number four. They do a really nice job, Gary, getting through the lane, setting up the open shooters.
Yeah. Yeah, they're famous for that, doing that weave, that three-man weave.
Well, and even so, when they get those rebounds, they kind of delve into the key a little bit across the floor, and the guys know how to get into the corners.
Well, yeah, that's what they're going to have to do to win this game.
Definitely. Anthony Kelly for three, no good. So Nippon missed their last three or four three-pointers. They got to avoid this kind of stuff. Because Vancouver comes back, and they were fortunate there that Hafford missed, and here they come back, the Tornadoes. Well,
like we talked about, you know, when the Nippon Tornadoes shoot, they have to either score on that first chance, or if they get a second chance, they need to score. Other than that, it's not going to happen.
Yeah, well, because the thing is, too, like we talked about, Gary, they can run the offense, their offense, they run the plays. However, if option one is blocked, they have a real hitch in getting option two put together. They had four shot clock violations in the first half last time we played them.
Yeah, that was because of the stifling defense, you know, double teaming. They haven't double teamed them yet, the Volcanoes, or had done any traps.
Well, and speaking of shot clock violations on the other side, good deed by Nippon. But speaking of that, Gary, give me my thoughts.
Speaking of defense.
It'd be about 10, 12 seconds left in the shot clock. Two Volcanoes would blitz the ball handler. So it was kind of that hidden, stifling defense.
Yeah, I'm not seeing that right now. In fact, I'm seeing in Nippon Tornadoes, the non-Japanese players have been setting up pretty good picks for them. So we'll see what that continues.
And Anthony Kelly was blocked right there from J.R. Moore. You got Tapscott down low. Leaner, no good. Good defense on that one for number five, Glenn Hollins. And Sasaki Hikaru.
There's that quickness.
And we have a nice Japanese contingent, like you said tonight, Gary. And then what was the organization that came in tonight?
The organization is called the Shokokai of Portland. And what Shokokai is, Portland is, a conglomerate, all the different Japanese businesses in the Portland, Vancouver area. And there's quite a bit more than you might think.
And that's also, isn't that who's housing the Rocket as well?
Right. One of the Shokokai business people is housing the Rocket. Very good. Gentleman Ito-san, Mr. Ito from SCH of America.
And that was a very nice move. It's very good to get the business from America and Japan and get that relationship solidified.
Right. Part of the advantage of Shokokai of Portland is to get involved with the Japanese community, whether it's on this side of the river or in Portland.
Nice no-look pass from Hollins. Over to number one, and a lefty layup for Hikaru Sasaki. Fake Jake Carlisle out a little bit.
Yeah, Sasaki last night scored 26 points. He's been averaging in the high to mid-20s.
He's a player. He's a player. And that's the thing. There's Josh Tarver, though. Inches, Gary. Pure inches. And a timeout on the floor. So still looking pretty good. The Tornadoes, they kind of withstood one dry spell. They don't need any more. We're going to take it to break, and when we come back, we'll talk more about dry spells and everything else. So, 5:35 left in the first quarter, Volcano 16, Tornadoes 12. All right, thank you.
I am here. Sure, no problem. Sounds great.
Why don't you give it to us and then we can intro her? Yeah, we can do that. Let's see. Let's wait till Nicole says she's got something this time.
You guys, it's so hard to hear anything.
Okay. Well, let's let her listen in on that huddle. Okay, looks like she's talking to Navarro really quick.
Okay, love it.
Okay, you got something, Nicole?
Yep.
Okay, well, get back to us, and then we'll set her up, and then She's got to find a cameraman.
Oh, cameraman. Gotcha.
All right, let's do it. Welcome back to IBL Basketball on FETV Channel 11, a Sunday night at the beginning of June 2013, and it finds the Vancouver Volcanoes sporting a perfect home record, getting later into the season, and they're trying to run their streak tonight some more against the pesky Nippon Tornadoes. And to find out a little more what was going on that last time out, it's Nicole DaCosta. Talk to us, Nicole. What do you have?
Into the huddle, you guys, and the coach was talking about defense. That's very important, defense going back after the break. And also, I mean, Japan, yes, like you guys were saying, they may be a little bit shorter, but if you just watch this game and squint your eyes, they're running around so fast. They are just working that ball. So let's see what happens. Back to you guys.
Thanks a bunch, Nicole. And Gary, what are you saying? You were talking about some of the quickness and some of the skill that they've been showing so far tonight.
Yeah, if Japan can continue to run their weave and use their quickness, I mean, that's their strength, the quickness, free throw shooting. But they've been playing pretty good defense so far. I mean, it's only a one possession game right now, Maverick. And right there, another tough defense game. So if they can use their quickness, sometimes speed kills. So, you know, watch out.
Yeah, Hara got his hand on the ball there before it went off of Ward's hand. So just enough. So bench players are coming in. Tyson Christie making his home debut for the 2013 season in for Hafford. And Dominguez getting ready to come in, Mr. Jeremiah. So we'll see what kind of dimension he adds to the floor, too. Boy, they needed that one. Yeah. If Hara could have got that one down, it would have been the lead.
I know, for the first time ever.
There we go. Good recovery there on the defense from Sasaki. And Tapscott facing two people.
Defense.
Yeah, good defense. And there's Anthony Kelly. He's got a couple of open players. He's going behind the back, and he's fouled. Yeah, Kelly, for that frame of his, he can handle the ball and really get up and down the floor.
Yeah, I bet you what the Nippon Tornadoes coach said, okay, I want you to double team or just get so close to them that I want to know what flavor gum they're chewing.
And I'll bet you it was on Mr. Tapscott probably the most. Yeah. So Mike Ward coming out, and in comes Jeremiah Dominguez. Coach of the Tornadoes is Ryotaro Onodera.
Yes. He's coached in the BJL League in Japan as well, so he knows the game.
Oh, excellent. So like we talked about, a real nice feeder system. Japan very committed to making themselves work in the IBL. Steal by Kelly. Oh, and a nice little look. But Hara's got to bring it back, but he's coming back in the paint.
Oh.
And Hollins, it's off. Goes to Jake Carlisle, up to Dominguez. Let's see what he does when he reads that floor. All right. The D on him's pretty close there, but Kosai Ban, he does get called for it,
though.
Yeah,
a little too close. Boy, you can see the confidence a little bit now shifting, Maverick, with the Tornadoes.
Yeah, they look real confident in what they're doing, and Tiefenthaler coming in for the Volcanoes. So on the floor for Vancouver, it's Tarver, Dominguez, Carlisle, Tiefenthaler, and Tyson Christie. Behind the back, over to Tiefenthaler. Yep, he did walk.
Yep.
I think he was thinking that three first.
He was.
He saw the opportunity to bring it in closer, which was fine, but the body didn't read what the mind wanted.
Body over mind or mind over body.
Yeah, exactly. Take your pick. So on the floor for the Tornadoes, it is Hara, it is Kelly, it is number 9, Sean Carter, it is Kosai Band number 2, and number 1, Hikaru Sasaki. Carter's real interesting. He's kind of like the cop, the traffic cop on the floor. He really directs people and what they're going to do. Halftime entertainment sitting there on the sideline, too. Looks like there's going to be a youth basketball exhibition, which will be really nice to have.
That'll
here.
Be fun.
And let's see, shot clock down to 2, down to 1. But Hara gets it off, but no good. And there comes Tarver. He's got Christie on the wing, but he's going to keep it. First and 10.
Yeah, kind of trying to imitate Andre there with that little football tuck.
I think you're right, because he had Christie breaking down, but he was confident in what he had going. So Tarver's going to go and 1. And so as we take a look, it's 18-14 Vancouver, 3:15 left in the first quarter. See if Tarver completes that three-point play. He sure does. So we'll see. I mean, I've been impressed with the Tornadoes, Gary, that as cold as the shooting has been, especially from three-point range, that they're still within striking distance at this point.
Yeah, they're playing good D. Then they have a little more confidence, I think, this game, Maverick, right now than the first game. last week.
Well, and it seems like they have a little bit more depth. It's really too bad Jordan Mast didn't make it in tonight. Such a nice score for them. And no good for Kosai Ban, and here come the Volcanoes. So Dominguez directing the traffic. Tiefenthaler over to the wing. Tyson Christie for a three. Not quite. And Carter skies for the rebound. Brings it over to Hara. Here come the Tornadoes. And Kosai gets past Dominguez. Feeds over.
Nice assist. Oh, you need to make those guys.
Yep, Carter blew the chippy. Yeah, they're ice cold right now from the field, Gary, and they need to get that stroke back pretty quick. And there's Dominguez for the three. Not quite. And loose ball collected by Ban. Up ahead to Sasaki. Nice dish.
Oh.
And Hara was fouled on the play. So they seem to be on the fast breaks, feeling it a little nice too, Gary. One thing I want to mention to you, though, I think the Tornado, they just don't have enough bench right now. And I think what you're seeing is Vancouver has sat all their starters now for the most part, brought in their second unit, and still maintaining the lead and stretching it a little bit.
Right.
I think the next time you see the starters out there, you might see a shift in momentum in this game.
I think you're exactly right because of the lack and depth of the Tornadoes. You know, these guys are going full steam right now. I mean, you go into that second quarter and going full steam. At some point, you're going to hit the wall.
Yeah, exactly, because Nippon has two guys that looks like they're playing off the bench. Tatsumi's not one of them, Gary.
No, I don't think so. Although,
He suited up.
Kind of. With his pants on, so yeah, I don't think kinda. He's going to play.
Well, that was your suggestion. What are you talking about? Ah, there's Dominguez for three. Welcome to Vancouver, Jeremiah. And a couple things I wanted to talk about, Mr. Dominguez. This is his fifth IBL campaign. He had three seasons in Portland, 09, 2010, 2011. Last year was with Salem, some great numbers. 15 games, over 18 points a game, and almost three rebounds a game, five assists, almost two steals. So he's very legitimate in the IBL. And he's been in Mexico overseas the past few years also.
Yeah, Volcanoes right now playing. There's another shot clock violation. So you can kind of tell now that the Tornadoes are kind of getting a little tired out because that three-point attempt there wasn't even close.
And there's number 34, the infamous Marcus Bradford, who we were talking about before the broadcast started.
Yes.
What did he do last night for them against Salem?
Bradford, he put up 29 points for Japan.
There we go. So that's a real nice shot in the arm for them, definitely. So 22-16 Volcanoes. So Japan, they're going to try like the Dickens to keep this thing close until they can get some three-pointers going.
Yeah, they're going to have to keep it down below double digits in reality, Mike.
Well, and they are a very legitimate three-point shooting team, so it's not too far out of the question that they can get on a hot streak. But it's just on the other end of the floor. Can they contain Vancouver?
Right.
And can they stop the turnovers?
Yeah, suspect defense, so it's going to be hard.
Christie, no such luck. And there's Bradford with it. He's got Ward right on him, though. And now let's see what the Tornadoes run. It's a pat on the head, Gary, so this should be pretty good. And there's Anthony Kelly for a three.
Oh, boy, you need to make those guys.
You got it.
You want a chance.
Dominguez is there, a minute to go. Let's see if Vancouver can capitalize. Nice find over there for Tyson Christie in the corner. Christie 0 for 3 so far. He's got to get his home legs under him. Oh, nice play by Dominguez. He stripped Bradford. Christie's got it. Over to Jeremiah. Oh, bounce pass led Tiefenthaler a bit too much. And here we go. Shot clock has been turned off for the rest of this quarter.
Yeah, they'll play for one.
Then again, I'm not thinking so, Gary. Well, maybe.
Yeah,
they
I'm
are.
I'm thinking they are.
9 seconds to go. They better get it moving. Here we go. Off the Kelly screen is Ban. Yeah.
Oh.
Turnover. 1-0. Did he get it? Yeah, count it. Tyson Christie beat the clock. A good way to end that first quarter. Had a tough go of it in the offseason, Gary, with some injuries, but he said he is good to go right now. And Navarro's like, love to have you back, because that's what he brings you. He brings you a very big presence on the floor. So we're going to take a break after this first quarter, and we're going to talk some more Volcanoes and Tornadoes and twisters and earthquakes and floods and everything else. So we'll be back to you very soon after a quarter. Volcanoes 24, Tornadoes 16. And we are back, the O'Connell Sports Center on the campus of Clark College, home to the Volcanoes 3 months out of the year, the most important months if you ask me. And after a quarter, the Volcanoes, seeking that perfect home record, are still successful, 24-16 over the Nippon Tornadoes. And we have Gary Akiyama with me, the man, the myth, the legend, and Mike Koreski talking at you here, FETV Channel 11. And Mr. A, talk to me as you peruse the stat sheet. What sticks out?
Well, obviously, rebounds really stick out. I mean, we have 18 to their 7. And when you're down 24-16, those rebounds are essential, to, you know, for the Nippon Tornadoes to convert. But they're not going to be able to do that. So 18-7, it really, it's the rebounding that's making the difference right now, Maverick.
Well, and let's talk about the shooting percentages, too. What does that look like?
Shooting percentages, we're 5 of 26. Nippon, 5 of 26. We're 11 of 19. Three-point attempts, which the Tornadoes desperately need. They're only 2 of 15. Well, we're only 1 of 7, but unfortunately, they need it more than we do. And free throws, everyone's perfect. Nippon's 4 of 4, and we're 1 of 1.
Well, and something good just happened there for the Tornadoes, Gary. That double team I was talking about showed up with like 12 seconds to go on the shot clock. They got out of it, and the American connection for the Tornadoes worked. Bradford found Carter, who now got fouled and is at the line.
Okay.
And it was right when the shot clock expired. So that was one of the first times I saw them beat that double team and able to freelance themselves up to an opportunity to score.
Yeah, that's going to be one of the other keys. Good point, Maverick, because if they can't penetrate the defense of the Volcanoes, it's going to be a long night.
Well, exactly. And Vancouver knows that Japan seems to, after the first option on the play doesn't happen, things kind of freeze up.
Yeah, they really only are playing with one option right now. It'd be nice if the Tornadoes could show two, but we'll see what happens here.
Well, and they continue to work over at that basketball academy in Seattle, Gary. They just continue to work. Tiefenthaler called over the back. Yep, he got a little too tall on Anthony Kelly there.
When did you think you'd say that? He got a little too tall.
Actually, I used to say that when I would rat ball back in the day when someone would come over someone for a rebound. I'd always say, he's getting tall. So there you go, Gary. Some rat ball terminology 101.
All right.
Courtesy of Wireless Mike, just for you. So Hara on Dominguez over in the corner, and that's Sasaki, and that is no. But Kelly picks it up. He tries the three. No. Sasaki gets it back. That ice-cold three-point shooting,
yeah.
Gary. They've got to get something going.
Yeah, they're living and dying by that.
Yeah. And so far, it's a death thing. Oh, Kelly weaving his way behind the back and shaking bake, and it's a loose ball. All right. The Tornadoes maintain possession, but Gary, look at the shot clock. 8 seconds. So they spent 14 seconds just in a haze.
Yeah,
just in a haze.
Normally you'd be able to go inside, but you know they can't. There's another three, Maverick. Does it drop? Okay, that drops.
And there we go. And the Japanese contingent is very happy at the moment. And something else, they held it up earlier in the game. There was a couple of Nippon Tornado towels, like dish towel size, that were being sold, Gary, at the concession stand, and they have a couple out there. Paul Hafford sinks the three, 27-21. So I'm really hoping, Gary, it's a sign of the IBL to come when the visiting teams bring in some merchandise.
Yeah, that'd be very good to do. You know, I think we should start that tradition that the Tornadoes have. Keep in mind, there's another three. Okay, they're dropping now, but the four of 19 now for the Tornadoes.
Yeah, but they hit their last two.
Yeah.
What have you done for me lately, Gary?
Right, right. And it's only a one-possession game now. So, like you said, Maverick, if they get hot on the threes,
sure,
you know, they're back in the game.
Well, then we don't have to fill the time with our bubbling personalities as much, do we?
Right. Yeah, so, we'll just throw it over to Nicole.
More of them, less of us. Oh, yeah, Nicole DaCosta. She's over there. She can groove the Nicole Tornadoes. She'll take it over.
Now, you guys.
All right, so there we go. Oh, nice move to the basket by Hara, but not quite. Yeah, 27-24, Volcanoes over the Tornadoes. And just a good ball game so far, Gary. The thing is, if they can get that shooting stroke going, like you said, to match some of the confidence that they're showing, it might make up for a while that lack of rebounding.
Right. Yeah, they're going to have to play very aggressive, play tenacious defense like Hara's doing right now.
Well, it's kind of the equivalent of baseball where all the things have to go right to pull the upset. You know, to pull that. You got to basically toss like a one or two hitter if the team has overpowered you by a lot, right?
Right. Now, keep in mind, the Tornadoes did that against the Kitsap Admirals earlier this season.
Yeah, yeah. So they tied their last year's win column, you know, win total already like their second week.
Right. So it's not to say it couldn't happen.
Yeah, and one loss to Salem a couple weeks ago, only by 12 points
right.
in Salem, which we lost to them. So they can hang. It's just a matter of they have to do what they can do for their advantage over us. Hafford does sink the second one, so 29-24 Volcanoes. And as we talked about the other night, Paul Hafford, second leading all-time IBL leading scorer.
Yeah, and his former teammate, Mr. Jacob Stevens from Bellingham's in the number one spot as of a few days ago anyway.
Well, and it's all the better because Hafford keeps dropping 30, 25, and all that, and Stevenson keeps dropping 25 and 30. So, and there's that shot clock violation once again, Gary. Yep. We talked about that.
Yep, they can't afford to have that happen. Now, speaking of Stevenson, you know, Bellingham beat Seattle last night, 105-91. Stevenson dropped in 27 points in that game.
There we go. Oh, beautiful bounce pass, but Mike Ward. And he knocked it off. He knocked it off of Sasaki. What did you think about that one? I think he might have pulled. He might have got it off him.
I think he did.
Yeah. All right. Tapscott in the post. There comes the double team. Yeah, they're double teaming Tapscott. They want someone else to beat him tonight, and it wasn't Hafford on that one. Shooter's touch, but not quite. Here comes Hara for the Tornadoes. He's going to pull it back.
Yeah, Kevon.
And there he
goes.
But Kevin West, get it out of here. Here's your invite for the block party, Takato. And then there's a fake and a germ. Chehalis Tapscott. And, yeah, let's take a replay on that guy. That was good stuff. Chehalis, did you see, Gary, that nice fake that he gave? And then he gave you the springs.
Yeah, Chehalis, you know, can do it all. Very pure all-around player. Smart player, too. He knew that the defender was there ready to go with him, even though the height advantage was to his favor. But nice dunk there.
So on this 30-second timeout, what do you think the coach for Nippon is telling the players?
Well, I think what he's telling them is, hey, you guys, you know, got to come out with tenacity once again. You know, and then you saw him throw his arms up. He said, you got to get up and act big. You got to play big underneath.
And talk to me about number six.
Number six there.
In the white there.
Yeah, Tatsumi Nishida, the assistant coach this year for the Nippon Tornadoes, but also the owner of the Tornadoes. And Tatsumi, what a great guy he is. I mean, he can just... you know, he knows the game, but he's the cook, he's the driver, he's the assistant coach, he's everything for these guys.
I tell you, I want a reality series filmed on that house in Seattle that they stay at.
I think we'll approach a Japanese TV station. I bet you they'd go for it.
I bet you they would. I'm serious. Okay, Gary, you need to mention that to Tatsumi, and I want to be in on the pitch.
Okay.
After the game, okay?
Okay.
You guys heard it here, FETV Channel 11. We could have some global television happening now. If you and I could narrate that, oh my goodness, that would be fantastic. All right, so the Tornado is working it around. There's Bradford for the deep three.
Nice deep three.
Second one in a row for Marcus.
We got a game here, Maverick.
Yeah, 31-27. Volcanoes, there's a steal. There's from Bradford. And there he goes, open court, and he flips it over. Oh no.
A little bit of a miscommunication. I know it's kind of frustrating for Bradford, but you know these guys, they'll get that. There they go. They're just saying, hey, don't worry, we'll get it next time.
Yeah, it seems like the American players are also very attentive. They know about getting the Nippon players involved, the Japanese players.
Well, and that's kind of their role, really. I mean, they want to teach them the offense and how to play defense. It's going to be the American players doing that. And I think, they're being very good instructors to help these guys out.
Yeah, instructing. Very good choice of words there, Gary. So Mike Ward, very athletic move, went to the left hand there over the outstretched arms of Sean Carter for the deuce. And there's Bradford. He's taking it solo. In and out, though. Almost
there.
A tip in by Hara.
Wow.
Here comes Vancouver, 6-point lead. And there's Tarver. He sees the floor like no other. Dominguez in the corner. Hafford for a three. Not quite, but Tapscott. There he goes over Kosai Band. But a steal from Carter. Over to Ban. Here we go. Let's see if the Tornadoes can get the advantage.
Look at that speed.
You bet. That was fast. And there's a three from Hara. Nope.
Nope. Got it. Oh.
Oh, there's a steal, though.
There's a steal.
Oh, they calling over and back on him?
It couldn't have been over and back.
Oh, man.
Really?
Really.
Wow. I don't know about that, Maverick.
Yeah, I agree with
you
there.
He was the defender. He wasn't on offense.
That's right. That's right. And he didn't do a stutter step where he kept himself in front there.
Yeah, I don't know about that one.
All right, Dominguez over to Hafford. Hafford gets tall there, Gary, with his arm up, positions the ball where Ban couldn't get it. And there's a turnover off of Tapscott.
And Tornadoes are catching on to that play now. If you notice, this is about the third time now they've trapped that ball underneath.
Yeah, well, they're trapping Tapscott. It's not even the ball. It's Tapscott. They right. knew number 20 was the one-man wrecking crew on him to the tune of 40 and 20 2 weeks ago. So very good adjustment. Kasai Bam.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Wow.
He's getting hot.
Woo.
He's getting hot. 33-30. Volcanoes. And there's Dominguez. Good help on the D. But Hafford answers back.
Yep.
Paul Hafford's a gamer. He's going to take it. So 36-30. Love the shot there on the sideline. Coach Onodera talking to Kelly, instructing him what's going on there. Just I love the instruction that Japan's trying to do with this IBL campaign, Gary, because it's all about the instruction is what they're going to right now. Not so much athleticism, but how to instruct everybody
with
what they want.
Now, we know that they won't win the league, obviously, as we've been mentioning, their first full season in the league, and it's really a learning season, but not to say that you can't win either.
Right. And under the game for the Tornadoes, Kuni Ito, number 23, as you called him, MJ.
That's his nickname, seriously.
Oh, my goodness. Good stuff. All right, so they hit the shot down there to close the gap. And it looks like Dominguez was fouled on the way to the hoop.
Yeah, MJ had 3 points last night's game against Salem.
Yeah, he seems to get a little bit of time off the bench in the second and the fourth quarter.
Right.
It looks like Coach Onodera has been trying to get him a few minutes here and there. He played on last year's team, and you can tell they needed some more depth. And speaking of more depth, we will go to break. But when we come back, you know we'll be talking. Volcanoes 36, Tornadoes 32. And back at you after the break, FETV Channel 11 Vancouver Volcano Basketball, the 2013 edition. They're wearing the nifty red uniforms tonight, Gary. Are these like the special occasion uniforms that some teams have or what?
Well, this is a funny story. I was texted earlier today from Tatsumi, and he says, we only have our white uniforms available tonight. Gary, can you make sure that either you can have the Volcanoes wear blue or red? So I had to get that around to Charlene and then to Brian Hunter and then to Joe Navarro. So that's how that ended up.
Nice, Gary. That's fantastic. And because they're usually home whites. So I think the special occasion uniforms aren't really a special occasion. They're like uniforms of necessity.
Right. Or the other team forgets their travel.
Exactly.
Jerseys.
Oh, number 5, Hollins. But Carter, he gets the rebound in with a left hand, puts it back in.
I tell you, I'm getting, this is incredible.
Tornadoes hanging in, 37-34, 5:25 left in the second quarter. Oh, and a tee up on Paul Hafford. He passed the official and said something real special.
Oh, really? Oh, wow.
Boy, he dribbled past him, and about 4 dribbles later, there was a tee. Oh, it's not
It
was on Japan?
Was it on Japan?
Boy, who was numbered?
I don't know.
I thought I saw a 3 with the referee. I wonder if it was Kelly over there, 34. I'm thinking so. Yeah, he looks pretty vocal right now.
I doubt if it was a Japanese player.
Okay, yeah. I'm thinking it was Anthony Kelly. All right. So, because Hafford passed the official, and about 5 steps later, teed up.
Yeah.
All right. So, more off the pick play. Over to Tarver. And Dominguez,
he's double teamed.
It's getting physical.
Yeah.
And there we go. Awesome Japanese fans, too. They're excited about it.
Yeah.
There were some arms up in the stands. I like it.
Jeremiah, so far, he's been, I can tell he's been a little frustrated of the Japanese defenders playing him so tight. And look at that.
I mean,
you can see what flavor gummy chewing.
Yeah, Kuni Ito. Yeah, if he's going to be in for a few minutes, you know, he's going to get his fouls.
I'm sure that was one of the instructions from the coach. You know, just play him tight and, you know, make something happen.
Well, and you saw Anthony Kelly go up there and give him a little pat on the back and, like, keep it coming.
Yeah.
So, yeah they're going to do it.
Yeah, these guys
8 seconds
going
to
it.
Go, and there's a pick for Moore, though, freeing up Dominguez into the teeth of the defense. Kicks it out to Hafford for a three. No. Rebound by Kelly. Here he goes in that open floor. He's pretty smooth when he does it. There's that behind the back, and he finds a cutting Hara.
Nice pass.
Over to number five.
Oh, they dropped Maverick.
There you go, and the crowd goes wild. The crowd goes wild for Glenn Hollins. And one.
38-36, 448. Who would have thunk it, Maverick?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Well, they worked it. All right, Jake Carlisle coming into the game. So 4:48 to go. You know Vancouver right now wants to get something going. And that's a three-point play for Hollins. Good movement there by the Tornadoes.
Yep. Well, you know, I think there's more fans here rooting for Japan right now than the Volcanoes.
Well, there's such an intriguing story. Not to take anything away from us, but, they're just an intriguing story because people just hear Japan and what's it like and what's it all about.
Right, right.
Yeah, they just love how much they're gamers, how much they come out here and the effort they put out. And like we talked about, one of the Seattle news stations did a story on him, showed him at the Seattle Basketball Academy. And like you were talking about, every day they're working, those Japanese players. Every single day working. It's their job.
That's their job. They're working 8-10-hour days. Look at the Japanese fans over there. They're loving it. Tatsumi Nishida, he's going, this
and
is...
There were a couple of those terrible towels over...
terrible towels.
Yeah, to coin the NFL phrase there. It was no disrespect on the design of the towel. It was just that football jargon for you.
Okay. And great defense again by the Tornadoes.
There we go. And there's Kelly on the floor. Open floor. There he goes. Oh, he's good at that behind the back thing. But there's a no call there.
Steal.
Pick off by Bradford. Over to Kuni Ito. All right. Back to Hara to set it up.
Yeah, he's setting it. Oh, the plane.
Open lane, but he gets blocked. Bradford picked it up, and he's fouled. Well, good things happen when you can get in the paint, Gary, and you have a couple of bodies there. A couple of things they've also changed, Gary, is the addition of Anthony Kelly tonight. With his ball handling, actually, he has allowed them to stay competitive on the fast break and has made them less prone to turnovers.
Yeah, you need someone like that to handle. Now, all of a sudden, at 3:38, we're tied up, Maverick.
Mm-hmm.
This could be, a game changer here, at least for this quarter, if they go ahead.
And also, number 34, the addition of Marcus Bradford tonight, too.
Yeah.
So the Kelly and Bradford, who we didn't see a couple weeks ago, are making up for not having Mast.
Yeah, absolutely.
So 38 apiece. And
first
there you
time
go.
They have the lead.
Holy tornado, Gary.
Yeah, mark it down.
We're down by
38, 38-39.
Yeah, Gary's marking it. All right, so there's Kuni Ito chasing around Dominguez. And there's Hafford for a three. Take it.
Paul always comes through with that, doesn't he?
Yep, Paul can shoot it any day of the week and any gym. So Japan coming back down by two, and there's Kelly for the three.
Ooh.
Nope. And no rebound. Tarver's got that.
MJ trying to steal it from Tarver.
Yeah, yep, he's been trying. Mike Ward. The bank was open. Not quite, but Ward gets it back. Over to Josh Tarver. Nice play for Vancouver. 43-39, under 3 minutes to go in the second quarter. So now, Gary, if you're Nippon, you want a very productive trip down the floor right now. You don't want the lead to get back after you worked so hard to take it.
Yeah, you want to. I think what you do is just spread it out, run your sets. If it's there, take it. If not, bring it back out.
And Bradford was fouled. He thought he had the leaner for an and one, but not quite. Mike Ward with the foul. And Ward, once again, it's his first run, too, since he got seriously hurt about a week or two ago.
Yeah, good to see Mike Ward back. We thought possibly he was done for the season. I'm glad that's not the case.
Yeah, that was the word.
Yeah.
But it's the Ibble. Because, see, it shows him as on the injured reserve. And then last two nights ago, it showed Gio Bain on the injured reserve, but he started. But he's truly on the injured reserve tonight.
Well, we just kind of a wait and see every game, really.
Yeah, I think so. It's always fun to come here, Gary, because you never know the storylines that are developing. So Bradford does hit that second one, 43-31, 2.5 to go in the second quarter. Dominguez trying to bring it up. Yeah, Kuni Ito, Gary, doing a good job.
Yeah.
But he dishes to Mike Ward. Nice cut.
Yep, somebody forgot about Ward there.
Yeah, and you can't do that. They haven't had the breakdowns like they had a couple weeks ago as well. There's Anthony Kelly. Looked awful good.
Yeah.
Oh-ho! Almost a rebound for Hara, but Dominguez sneaks in and steals it. And there's Josh Tarver for a three. Ring it up.
Okay, this is what the Volcanoes need to do now. Get that momentum back.
That's right. And there's Ward putting the pressure on Hara. Let's see what happens out of it and see if there's a double team that comes out of it. Kelly coming for the screen.
Oh, a little too quick.
Yeah, Hara went off the face of Kelly. Wasn't quite expecting it.
Hara did very well, though, against Mike Ward. I was impressed with his ball handling skills there.
Yeah, he did. He took that full court pressure on. He did a very nice job with it. In fact, Hara, he is their assist leader. 6 a game.
Wow, that's a lot of assists.
It sure is. And there's three for Mike Ward.
Mike Ward, shades of haunting us, remember when he was with Olympia.
You got it. Yeah, Carter even got a hand on it a little bit, too. So, yeah, Nippon, they need a hoop. Do they get one? Not quite there. Oh, but Sasaki had his position on it.
Yeah.
It just went off his hand. All right, so Navarro shouts it out to Dominguez what he wants. 1:29 left. They can kind of put the foot on him here a little bit, Gary.
Yeah. 10-point lead now. All of a sudden, double figures.
Yeah. And there's Dominguez.
Oh, nice pass.
Flips it to Mike Ward, and Mike Ward does a fake and drives it in. No luck. And there we go. There's a tip ahead to Sasaki. He's got it himself for a layup.
All right.
Good hoop for Japan. They needed that one.
Yep.
Needed that one. Now they need to stop. 1:04 left in the half. 51-43 Volcanoes. And now Kuni Ito went to the bench. Hara is now playing point D. Jake Carlisle. Oh, almost.
He was fouled, wasn't he?
Yeah, he sure was.
Yeah.
Too deep a position right there.
Big Jake.
Well, it seems when Tapscott's on the bench, they still don't do the double on the post as much. They did there, Gary, but it was too late.
Yeah.
So Hara's out and Kosai Ban coming in.
Yeah, good effort by Hara. Boy, he was just playing his heart out.
Yeah, he sure is. And 52 seconds left in the first half. So it will be interesting to hear from Coach Joe Navarro about adjustments and that kind of stuff here at the end of the half. See if they're a little bit surprised if the coaching staff is. They're kind of trying to do the mix and match thing with the new pieces and the pieces back from injured reserve and just joining the team and that kind of thing. So Carlisle does can the second one. 9-point lead, 50 seconds to go. So let's see if the Tornadoes can have a fruitful possession. Kosai Ban, there was the double team coming out. He has to give it up to Carter. Swings it to Marcus Bradford. Wanted to get a cutter, but it was off of Hafford's foot. And here we go, 6 seconds left. They just get a bit too deep in the shot clock when they come into these situations. So there is a timeout on the floor.
They're going to talk about it.
Yeah, they're going to talk about it. They really want to get a hoop here because, Gary, they want some momentum.
Absolutely.
Because after the effort they have put in this first half, you really don't want to go in there down by 11, 12 points.
Right.
That's just a moral victory, which is fine. But if you could keep this thing within single digits, that would be muy bueno. I don't know how to say very good in Japanese, Gary, so that's what you're going to get from me.
It's going to be Ichiban.
Ichiban.
You want to be number one going into halftime.
So that would be Ichiban.
you're picking up things good there.
So next Volcano home action is going to be this coming Saturday, June 8th, versus the East Bay Pitbulls. So one of the branding franchises from the Bay in Frisco there, coming in for their first look. I'm not sure they have on the roster yet. I haven't seen it on the website, IBL.com, for those of you who want to check that out, by the way. But it should be a good brand of basketball, I'm assuming.
Well, yeah, anytime you get a team from the Bay Area, they should do well. I don't think they've won a game yet, though, this season.
Well, they haven't started play yet, I don't think.
Yeah, you're right. This will be their – yeah, they've got a long road trip because they'll play Friday, June 7th. They'll play Salem, then play us on the 8th, the Volcanoes, Then they play Bellingham on the Sunday the 9th, kind of like what Japan did.
And Texas Strikers.
Three games in a row, so that will really test the team.
Well, if you have to do that Vancouver-Bellingham two-step,
it's going to be a rough road game.
Yeah, no, those guys aren't going to like a six-hour car drive from Vancouver to Bellingham. They're just not going to be down with it.
But, you know, that's what branding season's all about, though.
Well, yeah, and so far, that's the that's what we have in the Ibble for you. Welcome to the league.
Yeah, kind of baptism under fire.
I did see that Portland in for the two-game series versus the Lone Star Strikers. They did get the W last night.
Yeah, they won last night, and they'll play them again tonight, actually.
Probably right now.
Probably. The game's probably almost over.
Oh, yeah, because of the time difference.
Yeah.
All right, back to the action there. It was a three-pointer,
and it's good. That's a big ball
Marcus
victory.
Bradford, right when the shot clock went down. Closes it, 52-46.
They are all over, Josh. Look,
double team on. Dominguez splits it, though. He goes to Ward in the corner for a three. No. All right,
and
here we go.
Another opportunity.
Not quite. And there is bodies in the stands. Jake came in, saves it to Dominguez. 8 seconds to go. Vancouver wants that last shot. Sasaki on the D. Jeremiah wants him. Oh, he splits it. A big leaner. No. And they do count it.
They do count that.
They count Paul Hafford with the tip in.
Wow.
That's a little bit of a backbreaker, but you kept it under single digits, Gary.
Yep.
And that is the good news right there. So despite a strong effort from the Tornadoes, the Volcanoes are still up 54-46. Quickly, Gary, what have you noticed that's impressed you in this game?
Well, what's really impressed me now is the way the Volcanoes have come back, and you know, they were readjusting their offense. Their defense has been very stifling, kept them in the game. But give credit to the Tornadoes. They've been gamers. They've been sticking through. They haven't been giving up. I still think their confidence is good, though.
Yes, yes, that is good stuff. And we're waiting to hear from Coach Navarro about this first half. And as we do that, Gary, like you were talking about, a very good effort from the Tornadoes. Very good effort. The three-point shooting started falling. Marcus Bradford, huge for them, too.
Absolutely. Yeah, so, you know, it's going to be interesting to see what Joe has to say, how they're going to adjust to the second half, and if they're surprised by this.
Well, and here we go. We're going to find out if Joe is surprised. Nicole, take it away with the coach.
Josh Tarver, great first half. How are things going from your point of view?
We're being too cute with the ball. We need to be more aggressive shooting it. We're trying to overpass and try to make the Sports Center play instead of just shooting the ball.
That's an awesome way to describe it, being too cute. These guys are cute, aren't they? They sure bring out the family fun. So what's the plan then going into the second half?
We'll try to do some quick hitters, some early off-ball screen stuff, turn up the intensity on defense a bit. But we're okay. We're fine.
It's a tight score, but it's a great game to watch. We're having a lot of fun. Thanks, Coach.
And thank you very much, Nicole. So, Gary, being too cute, huh?
Well, you know, Joe likes to have intensity out there. He likes to have serious ball played. So when you say too cute, we're just trying to do things that we normally don't do. And so I think that's why it's a tighter game than it is.
Well, and I think so, too, Gary. The Tornadoes, they've got better double teaming down in the key when Tapsot's been getting it and Carlisle's been getting it. And then, like I said, the addition tonight of Kelly and Bradford have been huge for them.
Yeah. So it's going to be an interesting second half. Traditionally, we come out gangbusters in the third quarter here. So we'll see what happens.
Sounds good to me. So your halftime score, the Vancouver Volcanoes 54, the Nippon Tornadoes 46. We will be back at you for the second half real soon on FVTV Channel 11. And back at you, half number two coming your way in just a minute. The Vancouver Volcanoes versus the visiting Nippon Tornadoes. That's Anthony Kelly there, number 10. And Gary, talk to me about some stat sheet stuff. Talk about the importance of Anthony Kelly to Nippon's first half efforts.
Yeah, well, stat-wise, let's talk about the free throws, which really is keeping the Nippon Tornadoes in this game. 11 of 11, and we're 6 of 8. Assist-wise, they have 9, we have 15. So Anthony Kelly, Bradford, those are the guys that are really keeping this team in the game. Bradford with his 15 points, but Kelly, more importantly, with his tenacious defense and the way he's playing underneath the boards, you know, putting those stops on Chehalis Tapiscott and stealing the balls, just making things happen underneath there to cause a turnover for the Tornadoes to get that ball back and have some opportunities.
Yeah, he has 4 points and 4 steals and 4 boards. So it's like he's just a little bit of everything. And like I said before, his ball handling. He's not turning it over. He's getting out of double teams when he brings the ball up the floor, and they're getting more productive trips down the floor because of him.
Right. Yeah, and the other production is by Sasaki, you know, with 12 points. Sasaki had 26 points last night against Salem. But talk about your difference between the halftime score, 54 to 46. Last night when they played Salem, you know what the halftime score, Maverick, was 75 to 29 in favor of the Sabres. So dramatic change from last night to tonight.
Well, and that's what they needed. And once again, like I said, I think the scouting was good from Coach Onodara here, the adjustments they made from 2 weeks ago, and just the American players, the guys we didn't see, Bradford and Kelly, 2 weeks ago, have really made a difference.
Big difference.
The Tornadoes, they start with the ball here, and your starters, number 4, Takato Hara, number 10, Anthony Kelly, number 5, Glenn Hollins, number 2, Kosai Ban with the 3, no. And the 5th starter is number 1, Hikaru Sasaki. For the Canos, Josh Tarver there at the point, number 8, 20, Chehalis Tapscott. See if he can get his inside game going. 31, Paul Hafford coming off those screens. And Tapscott gets the wild pass shot from Tarver. And the lean out's no. J.R. Moore is in there as well. And number 11, Yasu the Rocket. And
nice behind the net.
Oh, but it was a little off, and Kelly had a little weird shot going. So Tapscott over to Hafford. Hafford driving on Kosai Ban. No. Kelly with the rebound. Up to Hara. Here we go. Oh, and he tried to get over to Hollins, but it was a little too late. Back out to Sasaki for a 3. You betcha.
Oh, watch out.
Way to start out that first shot of the second half for Hikaru Sasaki. And there's a steal.
Old Pipster steal.
Almost.
Wow.
Steal but no deal. Tatsumi Nishida really excited. Almost getting ready to go in the game there. 54-49 in favor of the Volcanoes.
Got a great heads up right now with the Nippon Tornadoes.
Well, and there's a few of those terrible towels there in the stands that the Japanese fans have on, courtesy of the Nippon Tornadoes, bringing their first merchandise in ever from a visiting IBL team. In all the history of us, this league, we haven't had someone else's merch here.
Yeah, I think that's a nice tradition to start.
Well, I think so, too. I've said it before, like in Major League Baseball, when a team comes in for 3 or 4 games, you can find their hats, especially at the merchandise booth with all your other gear of the home team.
There's your towel right there, Maverick.
Yeah, it said it right there. And what did it say, like road to NBA?
Road to the NBA.
Yeah.
That's the bottom line for the Nippon Tornadoes. There you go. Nippon Tornadoes, road to the NBA.
Yeah, they're serious. Like I said, serious as a heart attack. So 56-49 in favor of the Volcanoes. Ah, Kuniito, he's going to launch a 3.
Oh, my word, Maverick. 2 of 2 right now for the Tornadoes. And Ito just went in for Kosai Ban.
Yeah. Oh, the Rocket tried to answer, but no. The Rocket's been stifled a little bit. He had 12 attempts versus Japan 2 weeks ago, and he's barely looked tonight. But there's J.R. Moore using his height, pulling down that rebound and putting it in.
Yeah, there's no one stopping him on that one.
All right, 58-52 in favor of the Volcanoes. The Tornadoes coming back. Ooh, a little behind the back.
Oh, my word.
Nice play. And that was Hara with a little pastry.
Yeah.
Going over there to Hollins.
A little sweet in there.
I'm hungry now. 58-54 Volcanoes. Fun third quarter so far. J.R. Moore answers back. The big fella. Portland State, he's getting busy getting into the scorer's sheet. The first half for Moore wasn't so hot. Zeros pretty much across the board. He had one block, though, but he's already made himself into the scorer's column. So good for JR. Get his presence known.
Yeah, I think Haro was fouled there.
And here comes Sean Carter, number 9, in for 10, Anthony Kelly. Giving Kelly a nice little rest early on, so that's good. Kuni Ito coming out, Kosai Van back in. I think Coach Onodera probably had a couple of instructions, right?
Yeah, I'm certain of that. And they may be substituting more this half to try to stay in this game.
Well, and you can see Coach Onodera talking to Kelly on the chalkboard there, on the grease board. Hara for a three.
Oh, my word, 3 of 3, Maverick.
For the Tornadoes this third quarter, 60-57. And there's Tarver. Tarver being guarded by Kosai Band.
Look at that defense. Yep.
He's going to keep after it. Well, and there's Tatsumi Nishida. He's loving the effort right now. Very happy with that effort. Yeah, the characters are showing up right now. They're showing up. So, Bradford coming in for Kosai Band. How's Band's foul situation, Gary? Something going on there?
Let's take a look here. Kosai Band. Let's take a look. Oh, yeah, that made his fourth foul.
Ah, that's not a good thing.
No, that's not. That's not good for the Tornadoes. They need him.
No, they have the bench of only, they have only four guys. Looks like they're only playing three of them. So, yeah, not a good thing. All right, so Volcano's inbounding that ball. Tapscott's guarded by Hollins, but he gets it. And there's Hafford working on Sasaki. Almost. It was a nice right-handed flip there as he was going to the ground, and for that individual effort, he's going to the line. Coaches, Navarro and Christensen, you can tell Navarro's just like, come on now.
Yeah, right.
Come on.
What did we talk about at halftime?
Yeah, what happened 2 weeks ago? What are we talking about?
Right.
Let's take care of this.
You never take any team for granted.
That's very true, because once again, it's the
Ibble.
60-57 in favor of your Volcanoes, 9:07 left, third quarter. So Japan hanging in there quite a bit. And when they come back in a couple weeks at the end of June for our end-of-the-year barbecue final game of the season.
Yes, and I know, don't worry, I got your cheeseburger ready to go.
Oh, thank you so much, Gary. But I was going to say they're going to have karaoke. They're going to have massive karaoke by then, right?
That's what they're projecting, yeah. So when they have Masa back, that's going to change the dynamics once again on this team. Masa, you know, as you mentioned, was with the Summer League there with Joe Navarro down in L.A. last summer. And also he had a rookie tryout with the Charlotte Bobcats before the NBA went on strike.
As well as a handful of MBDL tryouts, too, last summer.
Right.
And there's Bradford with the turnaround.
Wow.
You bet. Carter got him a pass. 62-59 Volcanoes, but the Tornadoes are not going away. They are wreaking some havoc right now. Hafford off the screen. He pulls and pops. No. Rebound by Hollins. All right, and here we go. They're coming up. They want to get that run, and they don't want to walk it up. That's for sure. Hara under the baseline for three.
Oh, Maverick, this is what we were afraid of. 4 of 4. It's tied up.
Courtesy of Hikaru Sasaki. 62-62, 8:23 left. Third quarter. Wow, Gary. Didn't think this was coming.
No. Nope.
Really didn't.
Nope. Wouldn't have predicted this one.
And J.R. Moore flips over to Tarver. Shot clock down to 6. And that's Tapscott underneath against 3 people. There was a block by Carter, but Moore picks it up and dunks it.
That's what the Volcanoes are going to have to do. Just keep a big man underneath there, because you know no one's as tall as our big guys.
But Coach Onodera congratulating, encouraging Carter over there for his block on the play. And there's Bradford. Not quite. Carter tips it out to Saki. Over to Hara. They're resetting it.
Look at that quickness.
Not quite. Oh, rebound. Rebound by Carter. And a putback by Carter. Sean Carter. 64-64. 7:36 left. Third quarter. Yeah, Japan's getting busy on the boards.
They're getting busy. They're feeling very confident. And which is the one thing you don't want to have happen.
Tarver inside the three line, though.
Josh will have a say in that one.
Yeah, he breaks some momentum there that the Tornadoes were building. And Takato looking for something. The double team is on him. He kept the ball, but they counted a carry, or did they force him out of bounds, or they call a foul? Take your pick.
Looks like a foul on Tarver. Looks like a foul on Josh.
Yep,
I don't know what he did there. I thought he played them pretty nicely.
Yeah. And Paul Hafford there, he's guarding Sasaki, so we'll see what that matchup looks like, because Carter, once again, he's directing the traffic, Gary. He's like, Takato, come this way. And there he does.
Fourth foul on Tarver if that score clock's right.
Wow, interesting. And there's Carter. He's got a shot. He dumps it off to Anthony Kelly. No. Uh-oh. Hara's on the floor. He's not getting up. And they're saying, we need a sub. We need a sub, and we need something.
Oh, boy. He's hurt. He is holding his ankle big time.
Everyone coming out for that one.
Yeah, that is not a good sign. That's kind of shades of
Andre Murray on Friday. Yeah. Yeah, I don't like it. No. I don't like it. So they're working that out. The teams around him, seeing what's going on, checking in on some things. And I'm sure you'll be seeing a trainer in here pretty quick. Looks like they're going to be getting some ice, bandage, whatever you need to try to get him off the floor and get him in a better place. Tatsumi right there, too.
Yeah they got to carry him off. Yeah, that's not good.
Tatsumi's also a stretcher. Besides a driver, a cook, cheerleader, general manager, stretcher. And TV producer, if we have our way right.
Okay.
We will give him credit. We will give him producer credits. Tell you, we can get a package together, Gary, I tell you. So back to the game, though. Tapscott did score on the other end, is what it looks like to me. So that's 68-64 in favor of the Volcano. 6:52 left, third quarter. And the ankle there on Takato Hara. That is, that's the big question right now.
Yeah, it looks like he twisted that when he was going down.
Looks like he's retying it up, though. Yeah, you don't want to put too much, give it too much room, Gary, or it'll balloon up.
Right.
That's the truth. And if you want to play some more, you can't have that. Deep three, not quite. Holland's crash, but no. Tapscott's got it. Over to Mike Ward. He's penetrating. He's doing a double.
Oh! Nice block there.
Yeah, Kelly had a block from behind. Yeah, the rocket was coming down on the wing, Gary, but he didn't come in any further. Yasu seems like a little bit iffy tonight as far as where he's at on the court.
Right, yeah. I don't think he's got his confidence right now.
Ward takes the dribble, gets inside the three. No. A board for Hollins. They've really rebounded well this third quarter besides shoot the three, Gary.
Yes, they have. Yeah, they're really positioning themselves where they are going to get the rebound if that thing comes off the iron.
And it's the three-legged American stool of Hollins, Carter, and Bradford. Because remember we talked about it the other night, Gary, you need a three-legged stool in the IBL to really compete each ball game.
Oh, they called that one on JR. Looked like he blocked it, but...
Anthony Kelly coming in for Sean Carter. And once again, Onodara telling Kosai Ban, Make some adjustments. The Rocket's on him.
Yeah, he's into the game now. He knows that they have a chance of winning, pulling an upset here.
Yeah, you got that right. And flips over Kosai Ban for three.
Oh, my
at
word,
the buzzer,
Maverick.
At the buzzer, Gary.
Wow.
And the coaching staff, they're still just like, what is up? Christensen looks a little more shell-shocked than Navarro. There it is. Boy, Hara's getting taped up, Gary.
Yeah, that thing didn't look good at all.
Wow, and that's a strange angle, too, right there off the bleachers. I'm glad we have some space over there now.
Right.
Count the bucket for Chehalis Tapscott. So, dogfight going on now. Looks like Jeremiah Dominguez is going to be coming in for Mike Ward. See if he can change some things up. Timeout on the floor, and while they're working on Hara, we're going to work on a break. And when we come back, we'll have more of this game. Boy, what a great game so far. The Vancouver Volcano 70, the Nippon Tornadoes 67.
Hey, guys, look who I just ran into. What's your name?
Darian.
And this guy is all over the court all game long. You make miracles happen. You're sweeping. You're delivering Gatorade. What else do you do?
Connect with the players, just try to get cool with them so they like me, I like them. Help out with his son.
Very cool. How did you get this job?
My uncle, he's the general manager.
Very cool. And you're having a fun time?
Definitely.
What would you say to people out there that haven't come out to a game? Why should they come root on our Volcanoes?
People think it's just a little basketball. It's second step to almost NBA, and it's good basketball, and it's fun to go out to.
And you make this happen. So thanks so much. Have a great rest of the game and get out there and start sleeping. Back to you guys.
And thank you so much, Nicole DaCosta. Well, and that's what I try to do here. I try to get cool with Gary. That's what I try to do here. Sometimes I succeed. So thank you, Nicole, for that. Once again, another person of the organization, Gary, all shapes and ages and sizes and sexes that make it happen here at the O'Connell Sports Center.
Now, there's opportunities for anybody, you know, whether you're a little kid or a big kid like us.
Yeah, exactly. And you can get cool with the people here. So J.R. Moore is coming out. Jake Carlisle coming in. 71-67, Volcanoes up on the Tornadoes.
Oh, nice steal.
And there's Kelly with the steal. Flips up ahead to Bradford. A three for Bradford. Bammo!
Oh, wow.
Six of seven this quarter, Mavericks, well, for the
like
Tornadoes.
Five different players, too, Gary.
Yeah,
it's not just one guy.
Yeah, no, it's a host of them.
Like I was saying at the beginning of the broadcast, they have a talented squad of shooters. 71-70, 4:52 to go, third quarter. Chehalis Tapscott, nice little leaner. Good effort. Double team didn't quite get there, Gary.
Right. The Tornadoes are doing what they need to do, though. Like we said, they either got to, you know, use their speed, they got to shoot the three, and they got to make your free throws. And, man, these threes, 6 of 7 right now, obviously that's more than enough to keep them in the game.
Definitely. And there's Kelly trying to get some work on Carlisle. Anthony Kelly, not quite. Chehalis Tapscott pulls it down over to Jeremiah Dominguez in his Vancouver Volcano debut. Flips up ahead to Tapscott. Hafford in the corner for a three. No. And that's Bradford with the rebound up ahead to Kelly. Kelly's got one man to beat. He pulls it back out. Kosai Band flips over. Sasaki!
Ooh.
And there's Dominguez with the rebound. So some good ball movement, but nothing at the end of it yet. Tapscott, he gets it. Just too deep a position.
Yep.
Too deep a position deep for Sasaki. And I'm glad Sasaki didn't end up fouling him enough for the call.
No, that would have been a waste of a foul there.
Yeah, no bueno, as they say.
Right. Oh, my word.
And there's a three. Who hit that one, Gary?
Was that
Sasaki? Yeah, Sasaki with another one for Ikeru. 75-73 Volcanoes. Great third quarter. IBL action right here on FVTV Channel 11. You guys need to watch us more, and you need to come see a game especially. It's a crime if you're not out here for this. The ball is loose. Kelly knocked it away from Carlisle.
Oh, wow.
And what happened?
Oh.
Sasaki aggressive, but an aggressive foul, that's all right. They're getting after those loose balls.
Yeah, they're playing aggressive. I mean, really, like we talked about, they have nothing to lose, meaning the Tornadoes.
No, and something interesting, too. I just heard from Brian Hunter today. He was talking about the playoff format coming up, and there's going to be 3 days of games. And the first day, which is July 3rd, it is going to be the 5 versus the 4 team.
Oh, so they are going to have the 5.
Yeah, they're going to have a 5-4 play-in,
okay.
And then that winner gets the number 1 team on the second day, and then 2 and 3 square off.
Okay, good.
So Japan, Nippon, they're going to have a shot. They're number 5 right now. But if the playoffs started today, they'd be playing Portland, correct? Or Salem? Yeah, it looks like Portland.
Looks like Portland.
Yeah, percentage points behind Salem. So, yeah, Nippon, they have something to play for, Gary, most definitely. 76-73, 3:15 to go, third quarter. And there, Kosai Band splits the screen. And
he's fouled. He's fouled.
Dominguez. No, not Dominguez. Well, was it Tapscott or Christie? Might have been Christie. Yes,
yeah,
Tyson Christie with the foul. All right, 3:10 to go, third quarter. And Nippon bringing it in. Jake Carlisle overplays the pass to Kelly.
Yeah, that was telegraphed. I mean, I could have told you who was going to get that ball.
You could have reached out and stole it, too. 13 seconds to go on the shot clock. Let's see if there's a double team, one of those suffocating double teams. Nope, Kelly's going straight up on Jake.
Oh, Maverick.
Anthony Kelly, he's joining the three party for this third quarter.
We're tied up, 256, 76 up.
And Dominguez, can he answer back? You betcha he cannot right now.
The Tornadoes are positioning themselves very well underneath the basket on
defense.
That's
right. Kosai Band over to Kelly for three again.
Oh, nice effort there.
But Hollins, though, he chases it down. And the one referee needed a little help, so he goes over to the other referee who says Tornado basketball.
24 points by the Tornadoes this quarter alone on threes.
Yep, and that's what they needed, right?
Yep.
Kosai Band, he calls the play, 76 apiece. Let's see what happens. 18 to go on the shot clock. Over to Kelly. Oh, Mike Ward got his hand on it. But off a tap,
Scott. I think it's going to be Nippon Tornado Ball.
Yeah, it is. It is. Our guy's looking a little concerned. They're kind of looking bewildered.
Well, I think they are. They thought there was going to be a runaway game here, at least in their third quarter, and the guys are going like, wow, these guys are better than we thought on the threes.
Well, and they had a game Friday, Gary, which they took Salem out in the second half pretty hard.
Yeah, they did.
Mike Ward with the steal. He's got Dominguez on the wing, but he's going to keep it himself. No, but Tapscott
got the tap in.
Yep, Tapscott taps it in. And there is Hikaru Sasaki over to Kosai Ban. Here we go. Dominguez is on him. Flips it back to Sasaki. 7 seconds to go on the shot clock. They need something. They better get it moving. Ban says, I'll take that. But no. Hollins with the crash. But they called the foul on it.
Good effort, though,
That's
by
too
Hollins.
Bad. That's too bad.
That was a great effort.
Yeah, a fantastic effort. And like I said before, Gary, he's kind of been the one who's taken over the board work for them.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, someone's going to have to do that, and it's American players on the team. You know, not that it's obvious because of their height, but yeah, they're starting to gel. This is the whole Nippon Tornado team, Maverick, from a week ago actually till tonight. Mm-hmm. Big difference.
Oh, definitely. Well, you swap in a couple of American players, and your Japanese players are starting to shoot better, and the team itself is just really clicking.
And like you mentioned before, those workouts, 8 to 10 hours a day up there at the Seattle Basketball Academy is paying off.
Oh, yeah, it's their job, like we said. So Kevin West is going to enter the game for Chehalis Tapscott and timeout on the floor. And we'll see if they're going for a full or not as we wait for it. Well, I guess it's going to be a full one. So guess what? We're going to go to break. So right now, it's a close one, folks, razor close. 78 for the Volcanoes, 76 for the Tornadoes. Come on back, FBTV Channel 11. And we're back at you now on the campus of Clark College, the O'Connell Sports Center. And the Vancouver Volcano Dancers putting on their usual show, brought to you by Akiyama Financial. Doing things there and doing it their way. So right now, speaking of doing it their way, the Tornadoes, Gary Akiyama, 76 down by 2.
Yeah, one possession.
Yeah, what's up?
Well, you know, they're playing aggressive. They're playing with confidence. Their defense, believe it or not, they're positioning themselves very well, getting those rebounds, and that's been the key. But, of course, the biggest key is 8 of 9, 24 points just on 3 points alone this quarter, Maverick.
It's crazy, and it's been a multitude of Tornadoes, not just one or two guys. I think 5 different players have hit a 3 this quarter.
Yeah, you're right. Now, the only thing I'm worried about now is, can they keep up the momentum heading into this fourth quarter? We're still in the third with 147 left, but can they keep that momentum up? Because look at the Volcanoes on the bench. Holy smokes.
Well, there's so many people who can go out there and still get a run in, and then you look over at Nippon, and that injury to Takato Hara is not a good one.
No.
Because it's not really what he's doing in the stat sheet. It's just that he's one of their anchors, one of their minute eaters.
Right.
And their bench already was kind of thin, and it just gets a little bit thinner when something like that happens. But there is Marcus Bradford. Oh, my goodness. But he has been unconscious this third quarter, Gary.
Yeah, I can't wait to see the end of the third quarter stats.
So Dominguez driving on Kosai Ban. He's getting in there, and he flips it over. Tyson Christie flips over to Kevin West. Back to Mike Ward. Shot clock at 6. Ward in and out, Berger. But Kevin West.
To Kevin West right there.
He can leap. He's got hops. He's got hops. 81-78, Volcanoes. Oh, there's Anthony Kelly pulling up on that 3 on Jake Carlisle again.
Not quite on that one.
He thought Jake got a hand on it, and referee says yes. I think he did, Gary.
Okay.
So. Yeah, even though Jake likes what's up, I think the veteran move right there.
That was a good NBA veteran move.
Yeah, no, I think I thought I saw a hand on that. And there's Sean Carter working on West. And there's Bradford with the fadeaway.
Oh, my word, he is on fire.
Marcus Bradford equaling it from last night. He's had a heck of a weekend for the Tornadoes.
Yeah, 29 last night, on fire tonight.
And there we go, Dominguez. Flips to Mike Ward. Mike Ward moving over to the 2 slot when Dominguez comes in. Nice move under there for Mike Ward. So good to see him back, too.
Yeah.
So 83-80, 35 seconds to go in this third quarter. Let's see what Nippon can do. Once again, Gary, you don't want to have bad possessions. You don't want to have bad possessions. You want to have really good ones at the end of quarters.
Right, absolutely. Yeah, you just don't want to do any giveaways or turnovers, you know, because that'll just swing the momentum. That could kill you in a close game like this.
It's all about momentum, and poor Takato Hara.
Yeah.
A big looking ankle and a bunch of ice, and long term is what I worry for him more than anything. Dominguez behind the back to Mike Ward. He's going to keep it.
Okay, that's just exactly what you're talking about, Maverick. You can't afford to have that. Now it's a five-point game.
Well, and if you look at the replay on that, Gary, they just Ward, he was able to pick it off, and then they just kind of backed off him and let him have that. So they didn't pick the right move that time. Kosai Bam!
That was a smarter play.
He drew the foul. And I don't know if Dominguez knows, he's a decent three-point shooter, but it's not like he's money.
Right.
So, but he's going to get three, so that was a real nice momentum shifter with 1.6 seconds to go in the third quarter.
Yeah. Well, Jeremiah, he'll get back into the swing of this IBL season here. He's a gamer, he's a player, and he'll be, you know, that was just a smart play, really, by Kosai Bon.
Yeah, well, and Dominguez, he had his 2009 campaign in Portland, his rookie season for the IBL, over 21 points a game, 8.3 assists. And like we said last year with Olympia, 18.3 points a game and 5 assists. And he knows what to do in this game.
Japan made all three of those free throws, so they're perfect.
Oh, and Dominguez also almost had it. Perfect from the line, huh, Googs?
Yep, so far this game.
Well, we have got a fantastic game for you tonight, folks. FETV Channel 11. The Volcanoes want to extend that home court winning streak, but the Nippon Tornadoes, they want to pull the upset special. So we'll see what happens. One more quarter coming your way. It is the Volcanoes 85, the Tornadoes 83. And back at you, one more quarter to go. Coach Onodera of the Nippon Tornadoes, Tatsumi Nishida, GM, talking about some things on the rider board. What do you think, What do you think, Gary? What's going on?
Well, I think what they're saying is, you know what? Fourth quarter, guys, give it all we've got. We got nothing to lose. Play with intensity, stifling defense. And I would be surprised if they go back to double teaming in some instances. But, you know, they're going to live and die by the three, and so far they've been living by it, scoring 8 of 9 third quarter or 24 points, 14 of 14 from the free throw line. So it's going to be a gamer.
And something I liked a lot, Gary, was at the end of that huddle, the coach, he wiped the board clean while they were still in the huddle.
Wow.
I like that.
Yeah.
It's like, if you guys can't remember it, too bad. I'm erasing it, and you're just going to have to figure it out for yourselves.
There you go.
85-83, just starting that fourth quarter. And Tyson Christie goes over to Jeremiah Dominguez for a three. Nice start for the fourth quarter for the former Portland State product. So Dominguez, Mike Ward, Jake Carlisle, Kevin West, Tyson Christie into the game for the Volcanoes. For the Tornadoes, it is Anthony Kelly, Kosai Ban with the ball, Hikaru Sasaki in the corner, and right there is Marcus Bradford, and underneath is Sean Carter. Kosai Ban, no, West, good physicality there against Sean Carter to get that rebound. And there comes Mike Ward up, going back to Dominguez. Let's see if he gets another three-stroke here.
And Jeremiah, he can hit that three as well, so if he gets hot, you know, they'll put us back in the game.
Oh, Tyson Christie, it all looked good, but the end result. But Kevin West gets it? No. Dominguez fights for that board, and now he's going to... Oh, I thought he wanted it.
Yeah.
I think he wanted that, but let's see. Mike Ward on Sasaki. Let's see what happens. Little spin cycle. Good D by Sasaki. Flips it over to Kevin West, though. Little scoop? No. Good D by the Tornadoes that time. And here they come. Oh, to the cutter.
Oh, my word.
Bucket. Sean Carter from Marcus Bradford, 88-85. Tornadoes are not going anywhere. And Tapscott's coming in. Navarro now is like, let's get this going. Kevin West, no. Ooh, Jake and Kelly were tied up.
That was close.
Yeah, they were arm in arm on that one, Googs.
Yep.
Glad they didn't call a foul because I really don't know who had the advantage on that one. So Tapscott coming in for Carlisle. Carlisle talking to the coaches about that one a little bit. And here we go. So Kosai Band comes up. So fourth quarter to get it over the hump, what's needed besides more three-point shooting?
Well, after the Nippon Tornadoes, you need more three-point shooting. You need to control some boards at either one end or the other. If you're the Volcanoes, I really think you just need to put on pressure defense. I really think that defense is going to throw them off.
Anthony Kelly for the lean back, 88-87 Volcanoes. Yeah, they haven't really brought out that double team in the middle of the possession as much. And Dominguez is
out of bounds, I think.
Out of bounds. And Tarver coming in, and who's coming out? Mike Ward.
All right, give Mike a rest.
Yeah, give him a rest. Good comeback for him. He's had some really good looks, and he's looked real comfortable out there. So Navarro Christensen talking to Jake Carlisle a little bit about the game. And another thing, too, Gary, the Tornadoes, besides the three-pointers, they need to get real solid possessions. If they can get looks at the hoop, that would really help them out. Yeah. West with the steal. He's trying to beat Bradford.
He lost control there.
Oh, he did. He tried to throw it off Bradford. Kosai Band recovers. Did he take it off of Christie?
Yeah.
Lost it.
Good D there by Christie.
Yeah. Good hustle. Back on the hustle. Hustle matching hustle. And there's Jeremiah Dominguez. Slips it. Over to Tyson Christie for a three. He needs to get one someday, Gary.
Yep.
He's had a few good looks. Just hasn't been able to get it down yet. So Tapscott down low. He does the turnaround. No.
Oh, tip in.
Tip in by Tyson Christie, though. Christie's a worker, Gary. Yep. If that three's not falling, he's going to find another way to contribute.
Good make up there from the first one.
90-87 in favor of the Volcanoes. Anthony Kelly. That behind-the-back dribble is deceptive for a man his size.
What a game we're having, Maverick. Wow.
Yeah, this is good stuff. There's Tarver. Oh, it's out. Taps got over the back. No, but he pulls it down and gets it back up.
He's fouled.
Yeah, the positioning there, they didn't call it, but Tapscott, he's going to keep going. He's got a high motor.
Boy, if you're not here at this game, shame on you, man. You guys got to get down and see the Volcano basketball.
Well, year 9, it just keeps getting better. And next year, an anniversary year, Gary.
Ooh, the 10th anniversary.
I know, I'm looking forward to it so much just to say we've been around for 10 years as a franchise. That's fantastic. So right now you have Van talking to GM Nishida and Coach Onodara. Carter coming into the game for Hollins. And, I'm not sure why we're... Okay, here we go. All of a sudden, there's a little stall there, and I wasn't sure why. So Tapscott hands it, and through three quarters, Tapscott, 12 rebounds to go with 21 points. Not 40 and 20, though.
No, but, hey, he's doing the job, though.
And he's got another double-double. And actually, Gary, he is trying to get the record of consecutive double-doubles. That Bryson McKenzie, I think he's about 10 up on Tapscott still. Consecutive double-doubles.
Great. Good.
And Tapscott, every game this year so far, he has gone double-double.
Nice.
There's Kelly for a three. Wow, he's hot right now, Gary.
Yeah, he is real hot.
He is hot. Anthony Kelly is so hot right now. Yeah, 6 rebounds to go with 6 points, but he's hit a guy. That was through three quarters. He has a couple big ones now. Tapscott has to go away. Over to Hafford. Hafford wants to get in there, and he does.
Yep.
Nice leaning layup, 94-92. 8:13 to go in the game.
Good smart play by Hafford, knowing that no one's going to be able to stop him because of his height and his quickness there.
Well, and he's so good, Gary, about using his inside play to open up the outside. Kosai Band, no. Tip in for Glenn Hollins. Or is that Sean Carter? Was Carter or Hollins? Oh, it was Carter because Hollins is on the bench. Yeah. Tip in Sean Carter. And the ball, turnover on Vancouver. Nippon ball, tie ball game again. Volcanoes going to the bench. Mike Ward, Jake Carlisle in. Kevin West and Jeremiah Dominguez out.
All right, so you got the work crew back in.
That's right. Hafford, Tarver, Tapscott, Ward, and Carlisle versus Ban, Bradford, Sasaki, Kelly, and Carter.
Fans are really enjoying this game. Boy, this was a game that we thought was going to be probably over in the third quarter, but it's here we are, fourth quarter.
And there's Sasaki for the three at the buzzer.
No.
Tapscott pulls it down to Carlisle, and here we go. Paul Hafford looking for some daylight, and he sees it once again.
Nice, smart move, Paul Hafford.
Good job, Paul Hafford. Puts him up 96-94. And here we go. Kosai Ban. I don't know if I like him dribbling all the way down each time, Gary. I don't know if I like it.
Yeah, that could be a little concerning. Nice swift
there
move
it is.
There. Wide open.
Got a can it. Got a can it if you're Sean Carter. You got to can that. And there's Hafford. One guy to beat. He can't quite do it, but a chip in. Guess who? Chehalis Tapscott. He got in there.
Yep. So here's the difference right now, Maverick. Within the fourth quarter, Nippon Tornadoes on the 3 points where they live and die by it. 1 of 5.
Craziness.
But they're only down by 2 possessions, but still, you know, they've got to make those if they want any chance of staying in this game.
Well, and the thing is, like we talked about, momentum. Now we're coming into under 7 minutes to go, and some of those plays, just they mount up on you. They just mount up on you. So 99-94 Vancouver, the Tornadoes need an answer. Kosai Ban takes a look up there, and he's like, I got some work to do.
Yeah, so let's see Hara on the bench there and propping his feet up there,
yep,
icing it up.
That's true. He's still there. Really unfortunate turn of events for them tonight. And there is Bradford. Splits it to Sasaki for three. Hikaru. Nice look, too, from Bradford to find him. And he's shouting out some instructions on who's covering who. And here we go. Tarver wants to go to the rack. Van cuts him off. Over to Tapscott. Back to Tarver.
Tarver's mismatch. If
over
can
to Tapscott for three. Beautiful. Beautiful. And he takes a grin over there at Carter. Nice little grin for him to Carter. And Tarver's got a grin going. 102-96. There's a bounce pass down to Sean Carter. Facing up on Carlisle. Goes to Anthony Kelly. Step back. Oh! Tapscott with the block. Up ahead, Hafford. He wants to go the distance, but he flips it over.
Yep.
Dos puntos, Sean Tarver.
Yeah, this could be the difference. Mark that at 6 minutes and 5:40 in the game. That could be where the thing starts to change.
It could be because the Tornadoes all of a sudden are doing a little more 1-on-5. The rebounding's not there, and they're looking a little tired.
Yeah, they are definitely tired.
And Hafford, spin cycle on Bradford. No. Kelly fighting for the board over Tapscott, and they give it to the Tornadoes.
Tornadoes want to talk about it and try to at least regroup to get back in this game.
All right, and it's a dandy. 5:18 left to go in the game. Volcanoes 104, the Tornadoes 96. We'll be back shortly. And back at you, O'Connell Sports Center on the campus of Clark College. IBL action for you. Great stuff tonight. It's the Vancouver Volcanoes 104, Nippon Tornadoes 96. Vancouver's looking for an 8-0 home record, Gary, with 3 to go. How's it looking?
I think we're looking good. We just got to keep up the momentum, keep up the pace, deny the 3 points with Nippon Tornadoes and get the boards, and we should be fine.
Yeah, like I said, they're starting to look a little tired. The possessions aren't quite as wide open as they were. Carter tried to dump it into Kelly, and Jake Carlisle slid down there. When they were getting their open looks, Gary, in that third quarter, there was a lot of streaking across the key and finding the guys in the quarter.
Right.
In the corners, and they haven't been able to quite do that as much. Kosai Ban. Over. Oh, nice play, Marcus Bradford.
Bradford's on fire, I'll tell you.
Nice move for him. Boy, he's done a whale of a job tonight.
He wants this game.
Yeah, he does. What a gamer. And there's Ward. Kosai Ban on him, or on Tarver. And there's Jake Carlisle. Not quite. Ward, though, with the tip. Over Sasaki. Muscle move right there. Right there. Mike Ward manned up. 106-98. 4:32 to go. Yeah, Mike Ward, real nice comeback for him. Nice welcome back.
Yes.
And let's see what we got going here.
And as the game progresses on here, Maverick, you can see how much they're missing Hara because, like you mentioned, they're not doing the weave. They're not interchanging, you know, cross court. So that's a factor.
Oh, nice Taft got on the block on Bradford. Ward picks it up. Bullet pass to Hafford. Not quite. But Navarro loved it. Joe Navarro loved it.
Yeah.
Mike Ward through three quarters, 11 points, 5 assists, and no turnovers and a steal. And he has just added to that in this fourth quarter. All right.
Kosai
Ban wide open.
Oh, big foul there.
Tapscott gives him a little bit how you doing.
Kind of a welcome to the IBL.
Yep, exactly. Yeah, even when that open lane's there, be prepared for it to close down. All right, so still the 8-point lead, Kosai Ban. And here's that free throw shooting you were talking about, Gary.
They're still perfect.
Yeah, perfect. Real good show for the contingent that came out tonight for the Tornadoes.
Oh, yes, Shokokai of Portland. I bet you there's about 50 people there.
And there's your first miss, though.
First miss.
And they flew in the national anthem singer, you were saying. What was the deal behind that?
Well, you know, they wanted to... this guy that came in, actually, in Japan is a well-known singer in Japan. He is.
Wow.
National recording star over there. And so they wanted to kind of show off a little bit, but also they know that the Tornadoes have other games on the schedule coming up, and so I'm sure he's going to stick around and sing at those games too.
Tapscott, a little turnaround jumper. He gets it. So they're making their push. They're making their final push to put it out of reach. Tornadoes need to get it going.
Yep, three-possession game.
Navarro's up, and he's urging his players, get aggressive. Get aggressive on the D.
They've been pretty quiet on the three.
And there's Kelly, shaking and baking. There he goes. Little leaner.
Oh.
Not quite. That was going down in the first three quarters. Not right now.
Yep.
Oh, Kosai Ban.
Oh, the old pipster.
All right, and there's Bradford with the steal. He's coming in. He wants it. And there's a foul on Tarver.
Yeah, he's hacked.
Oh, Nippon not going away.
No.
Real good reaction there. Tatsumi cheering his guys on, uniform and all.
Yeah, Tatsumi loves this. I mean, the closer, the better. And he deserves this. You know, the guys have been working hard, and I'm glad they're playing a good game.
Totally with you, Gary. Totally with you. And it's just better for the league when you have the competition every night.
Right.
When you can have it there. Because it's fine if you have Vancouver and Bellingham always sitting at the top, but you have to have
fans
people to challenge
from Japan
them.
Really appreciating the effort by the Nippon Tornadoes tonight.
That's right. They're wearing the terrible towels. Not waving them yet. Maybe we can teach them that, Gary.
Okay.
How to wave that terrible towel. Get some NFL going on here. And second free throw, no. 108-100, 3:03 to go. So that was the halftime deficit. Stayed there right now.
Yep.
All right, Tarver to Tapscott. Back to Tarver. He wants to create. He's directing. He's got a screen. Oh, goes to Tapscott. Oh, ball is loose. And Kosai Ban picks it up. Good defense for the Volcanoes. Bradford taking a look. Kelly sets the pick. Over to Ban. 14 seconds to go. Down to Sean Carter. And a cutter. No. Picked off by Tapscott. He's got a man ahead of him. Paul Hafford. Lay up. Get that replay out here. Let's take a look at that again. Great individual effort. Great individual effort by Tapscott and Hafford. 110-100, chance of defense come out here for the Volcano fans in attendance tonight. Tapscott got his hand on the pass. Anthony Kelly.
That could be.
Here comes a highlight.
Yep. That will pretty much mark that 159, 112 to 100. I think that's what put it over the top, man.
I think so. And if you look on the replay there, it was just Kelly just got a little bit tired on that pass. I think that's what you saw.
Yeah, he was tired.
He's just getting tired. And okay, out on Hafford. Tornado ball, 10 seconds to go.
You know, these guys have been just warriors tonight, both teams. I mean, I'm just totally impressed with all Isle effort.
Yeah, I have too. The Volcanoes, they've responded with when they've had to. The Tornadoes, they just keep trying. Loose ball, Volcano ball. Minute 37 to go. And here we go. Timeout on the play. Timeout on the floor. So there you have it. The fans are getting ready here, getting ready to celebrate. And we'll celebrate when we get back, too. Put on those earphones. It's going to be a doozy. Volcanoes 112, Tornadoes 100. We'll be back. And back at you here. It's a minute 37 to go. Looks like the Volcanoes might have this one in the bag. 112 to 100 over the Nippon Tornadoes. And with us right now, she just sat in on the Japan huddle, Nicole DaCosta. What was going on there?
The rock music is on and people are more pumped than ever. It looks like they might do some sort of clean break down the middle. I was trying to do a little spy action here, but it's anyone's game at this point. I know it's been pretty intense the whole game. 12, let's see if we can hold it. Back to you guys.
Thank you very much, Nicole. Yep, we asked her to go behind enemy lines with the other team there, and she did, so congrats. So Tarver, no good. Close eye Bam picks it up. Here comes Nippon. They need some points, and they need them in a hurry. Bradford with the three. That gets it started. 112-103.
They got to get a stop here.
And there's close eye Bam. Oh, nasty pick
right
from Tapscott.
Right into a brick wall.
Yep. No help on that play. But Kosai is not to be determined, not to be deterred. And Sasaki trying to get something on Mike Ward. The shot clock's down to five. Offensive foul on Jake Carlisle.
Wow.
Uh-oh.
Wouldn't have thought that.
Me neither.
Jake's going, really?
Seriously? And the Boo Birds are out. The Boo Birds.
Well, obviously what the Tornadoes need to do is score now and score very quickly.
Yeah. They need to get a shot up pretty quick. And let the chips fall where they may after they make another shot. Yeah, let's see what's up. So Kosai comes up. The ball got loose. Mike Ward, assist.
Oh, statement. Big statement there, Mark.
A little sour cream on the baked potato tonight for Paul Hafford. Replay time for you guys as well. Carter can't get the tip in. He hurt his finger or something. Not doing very well. There's a foul on the play. So the Tornadoes, Gary, kept fighting.
Yeah, I'm impressed. I mean, you know, we talked about the last game. They just need to do little steps to improve. I think they took a pretty giant step tonight. I really do.
Well, especially since Takato Hara went out in the third quarter.
Yeah.
Ito coming in. We'll see who he comes into to finish out.
Yeah, we hope Hara's back sooner than
comes
later.
Comes in for Bradford. What a whale of a game tonight for Marcus Bradford.
Oh, incredible game.
Good stuff for him. And Hafford tips it over to Tarver. Yeah, Ito gets him. It's kind of like Ito and Ban. They're kind of like fast predators.
Yes.
It's like you get the ball and it's like they smell blood.
Right. Kind of like Jurassic Park.
Yes. Exactly. I was going to say don't feed them after midnight, but that's gremlins.
Okay.
Which we don't want anyone to multiply when you have the ball and the defenders are running at you. So 115 to 103, Tarver getting some free throws in. And just a good ball game tonight, Gary. The score, I know the saying is always there, but the score wasn't indicative of the final on this one.
No, it was not. It was a great game to be at, and hats off to the Nippon Tornadoes for their gallant effort.
Big time. Sasaki, no. The ball is loose. Kelly tried to pick it up. Tapscott picks it up. Over to Hafford. Hafford, despite the defense of Ito, brings it over to Carlisle. Back to Hafford. Ban falls into the Vancouver Volcano bench. 8 seconds to go, and they're really trying to get that ball. He flips to Mike Ward. Bounce pass. Jake Carlisle.
Yeah.
Nice play. 10 seconds to go. And there we go. And our announcer, Witt, he says, that's what I'm talking about. And we will agree. Kosai Ban to Kuni Ito to finish.
Oh.
Nice job for him to finish up. Yep. So looks like your final, 118 to 105. Vancouver wins it. It was thrilling, though, Gary. There's a standing O here, too. Some of the Vancouver fans are giving the Japanese players a standing O for their effort on this one.
Yeah, both sides are standing for both teams. I mean, that's a great way to end the ball game when you appreciate both teams.
Well, on the three-pointers, you know, they were going off in the third quarter there for the Tornadoes.
Yeah, what they did was, you know, in the after the third quarter, they were 8 of 9. They were 3 of 7 in the fourth quarter. So between the two quarters, they were 11 of 16, 33 points. That's a lot of points in any game, Maverick, for three-pointers.
That's a whole lot of them. As you see there, Ban and Kuni Ito congratulating each other. And there you have the Tapscott and the Bradford talking, and just a very good effort tonight for both squads. And I'm really happy to see the Tornadoes come out and compete like they have.
Yeah, if we look at the stats here, Bradford Maverick ends up with 32 points. Tremendous, 5 of 7 from three-point land. Sasaki, 18 points, 4 of 10 from three-point land. Jose Bond, 13 points, 3 of 10 from three-point land. So it kept them in the game, but not quite good enough when you're playing against the Vancouver Volcanoes.
I agree with you totally. And it looks like we have the player of the game with our very own Nicole Costa. Who is it, Nicole DaCosta?
What's up, Mike Ward? There is a reason there is a one on his jersey tonight. And he told me he's feeling pretty good. Feeling good?
Yes, feeling great. After an injury, you know, I got half last weekend. Feeling good, come back, you know, be with the guys, kind of miss them. So feeling good.
Oh, you guys missed each other. That's cute. And are you going to miss Japan when they're gone?
Definitely. They're a great team. You know, with the Americans they got on their team, they picked up a great asset to their team, so they're a tough team.
Oh, yeah. Quick ball movement tonight. You guys were all over the place. They could not sweep up the sweat fast enough. It was so fast-paced. I mean, are you guys exhausted?
No, not exhausted. You know, that's the way we play. We like to play up-tempo, and so that's the game, kind of game like we like to play.
Yeah. Well, you played great tonight. Thanks so much. Go get some rest. Thanks, you guys.
And thank you, Nicole DaCosta. Great addition to our team. And there we go. There is the contingent that was there getting their picture with the Tornadoes.
Yeah, what a great tradition. They do that after every game in Japan, of course, carry it on here. And they're very proud of their Nippon Tornadoes, not only the Japanese players, but the American players that have graciously, you know, helped the team out. So it's a great sportsmanship all around, Maverick.
Well, it's like we talked about, Gary, the American players are very much tutoring the Japanese players. On the floor, on the sideline, and it's just a really nice thing to see.
I can tell you there is total respect from both sides, and boy, I wish the rest of the world could be like that. I mean, there you see some signs there for the Rockets. You know, they're just really enthused also of having the Rocket on the playing for a USA IBL team. So it's pride all the way around. And just great relationships between the two countries anyway.
That's right. So how did the Volcanoes turn back the Japanese charge in that third quarter? And in the fourth quarter, what did they finally do that got them the W?
Well, I think what they finally did was, you know, got the breaks. They took advantage of Hara being out, took advantage of their lack of quickness, and took advantage of the 3 points not dropping for them. And fortunately, we converted and got the assist and rebound. So we just, you know, good teams step up in difficult circumstances and in close games, and the Volcanoes did exactly that.
Well, and something interesting, there's still some coaching going on with Christensen talking to Christy and Jay O'Mara about something going on there. There's the Rocket. He's still a celebrity, even though he's with us. He's still a celebrity, and it was really fun, some stuff he was doing at halftime there with the guys who have the Yas Rocket sign, his fan club there. He was doing something funky. See, there he goes posing. There he goes. I think he learned that from you, Gary, as far as the showmanship. And, Nicole DaCosta, she's ready for something, aren't you, Nicole?
All right, you guys, we had such a good time, and it's all thanks to these fine ladies keeping the momentum up. How did you guys... This is very, very exciting. Alex might need to check it out. You guys did an awesome, awesome job tonight.
There we go. Nicole, she was on the scene.
Oh, you got
there, we go.
Okay,
there we go. It's on you.
Thanks, ladies.
And thank you very much, Nicole, and the Volcano Dancers, Gary. Such a part of the Vancouver Volcano experience.
Yes. And there they are carrying out the Nippon Tornadoes Hara that got injured Great gamesmanship there, too. I mean, they really care about each other, and you just can't find that anywhere else, Maverick.
I agree with you totally. So speaking of caring about each other, the Volcanoes have another game here, and it's coming up Saturday, the 8th, against the East Bay Pit Bulls. Quick preview. What do we got?
Well, East Bay Pit Bulls, you know, from the San Francisco Bay Area. We got to look at their roster. We haven't seen that yet, not online, but we'll look it up, Maverick. And that game, unfortunately, I'm going to miss because I have a more important date with my youngest daughter graduating from high school. So I'll miss you on that game, but we'll catch you in the next games coming up.
Well, congrats on the graduation, but all I can say about you is lame. Just kidding, Googs. Just kidding. You know I love you. So here we go. We're going to wrap it up tonight. Thanks for sticking around with us on FBTV Channel 11. The Volcanoes finish it up. Still unbeaten, 8-0 home record on this 2013 season. 118-105 final. Have a great evening, Vancouver. For Nicole DaCosta, this is Mike Koreski and Gary Akiyama signing off. Have a great evening, Vancouver. Thank you for watching.